Hello, we often hear that scientists are still trying to put humans on Mars. But is it easy to live on Mars? What is the habitat on Mars like? Let's find out together in this video. Astronomers often refer to Mars as the Earth's twin because of its similarities to Earth. It is the second most habitable planet in the solar system, at least by NASA standards. Like Earth, Mars has ice at both poles with evidence of surface and subsurface water, a day lasting about more than 24 hours, and a tilted axis that causes seasonal variations. However, the above is all that Mars and Earth have in common, but looking closely, Mars and Earth are very different and living on this planet is extremely difficult. First, let's talk about the weather on Mars. Unlike Earth, Mars has no magnetosphere. In fact, according to many studies, Mars had a magnetosphere about 4 billion years ago, but it has been lost over time. But the magnetosphere plays an important role in blocking dangerous radiation from the Sun, plus the thin atmosphere of Mars makes the radiation on its surface many times higher than on Earth. On Earth, humans are normally exposed to radiation of about 6.2 MSV per year, but on the surface of Mars, the amount of radiation will be 244 MSV per year, about the same as a worker in a nuclear power plant. With this radiation intensity, humans are very susceptible to acute radiation sickness, cancer, genetic damage, and even death. And to combat this radiation or to have a safe environment like on the Earth's surface, we need to hide under a 15 centimeters thick steel roof, 1 meter of rock or 3 meters of water, or have to live underground. The atmosphere on Mars is not only very thin, but extremely thin. Measured at the surface, the average air pressure is about 0.636 kilopascals, which is 0.6% of the Earth's pressure at sea level or the Earth's atmospheric pressure at an altitude of 38 kilometers. And while Earth's atmosphere is composed of 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, Mars' atmosphere is a toxic plume of gas composed of 96% carbon dioxide, 2.6% nitrogen, 1.9% argon, carbon monoxide, and water vapor. Humans would not be able to live with these gases. Because Mars is about 50% farther from the Sun than the Earth, it has a thin atmosphere that absorbs less heat from the Sun, so the average surface temperature on Mars is very cold, about minus 63 degrees Celsius, colder than the coldest place at the Earth's Antarctic is minus 61 degrees Celsius. However, that's not the scariest thing. The temperature change on Mars makes us helpless. If during the day the temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, at night the temperature can drop to minus 135 degrees Celsius. The temperature on Mars is so bizarre that if you stood on its ground, the soles of your feet may feel warm, but your ankles already feel cold and your knees up may be frozen like a fish in the refrigerator. Next, another problem to overcome is that gravity on Mars is very weak. Mars' gravity is only close to 38% of Earth's gravity. The difference in gravity can negatively affect human health by weakening bones and muscles and causing cardiovascular problems. The cardiovascular effects are complex. On Earth, the body's blood is 70% below the heart, but in the absence of gravity, there is nothing to pull the blood down. This causes the pressure in the lower body and legs to drop significantly. As a result, the legs become weak due to loss of muscle and bone mass. Astronauts show signs of puffy faces and chicken feet syndrome while living in zero gravity on the ISS space station. After their first day back to Earth, blood samples showed they lost 17% of their plasma. Upon their return to Earth, the astronauts were observed to have a multitude of symptoms, including cold sweats, nausea, and intoxication, not motion sickness, but Earth sickness. In general, gravity makes it difficult for us not only to move on Mars, but also causes the human body to have many health problems. Another problem is dust storms. Dust storms are a regular phenomenon on Mars and occur whenever the lower atmosphere warms up. If you've seen sandstorms in the desert and see how scary it is, it's actually nothing compared to dust storms on Mars. The Martian dust storm has a much larger scale, which can be tens of kilometers high, thousands of kilometers wide, even covering the entire planet, and it is also known as a global dust storm. When a dust storm occurs, everything on the surface of Mars can be lifted up into the sky and destroyed. One of the Earth's probes is also damaged by the dust storm. Not only that, when the dust storm lasts, the dust is suspended in the air. It will block the Sun, leaving Mars in darkness and cold. Such an environment is very difficult to live in. In addition to dust storms, radiation, super cold temperatures, and toxic atmosphere, humans want to live on Mars. We need water, food, and energy. Fortunately, Mars has permafrost to provide an abundant amount of water, but it is not clear if this water is toxic or not. Regarding food, scientists say potatoes can live and grow on Mars. It will provide a necessary food source. In addition, in the Mars simulation environment on Earth, The researchers also discovered that some lichens and cyanobacteria survived and showed the ability to adapt to the Martian conditions and to photosynthesize for at least 34 days. As for energy, neither solar nor wind power is feasible because Mars has a weak amount of sunlight and it has many dust storms that can blow them all away. Fortunately, scientists at NASA in China are developing mini nuclear generators, which can generate electricity continuously for 10 years with a weight of only a few tens of kilograms. Thus, in general, life on Mars is possible, but it is 10,000 times more difficult than improving the habitat on Earth. Why do we destroy the Earth, destroy nature, and then spend mountains of money to find a way to live on an extremely inhospitable planet? Really hard to understand. Thank you for watching the video, goodbye, and see you again.